The human brain is an incredibly complex organ, constantly processing vast amounts of information to make predictions about the world around us. This predictive capability allows us to navigate our environment with remarkable efficiency and adaptability. At its core, the brain uses past experiences to form models of the world, which it then uses to predict future events. This process is ongoing and involves making hypotheses, testing them against reality, and adjusting based on new information, a fundamental aspect of human cognition known as predictive processing. Predictive processing is a theory about how the brain operates. It suggests that rather than passively responding to stimuli, the brain actively predicts the sensory input it receives, constantly updating these predictions based on new data. This model posits that the brain functions much like a scientist, formulating hypotheses, predictions about the external world, and then testing those hypotheses against the incoming sensory information. By considering our brain as an active participant in the creation of our experiential reality, predictive processing offers a lens through which to view human behavior, learning, and adaptation. A classic example of predictive processing in action is visual perception. Our brain predicts what we will see as we move through the world, based on previous experiences and contextual clues. This is against what most people think about our vision. Many assume that we passively receive and process visual information as it comes, like a camera taking a picture. However, our perception is much more proactive. The brain does not simply take in what the eyes see. It constructs a version of reality based on the mix of current sensory input and past experiences. This predictive mechanism allows us to process visual information more efficiently, focusing our attention on discrepancies or changes that may signal new or important information. Imagine you are walking through a forest you've never visited before. Your brain begins to predict what you may encounter based on your past experiences in similar environments. Your brain expects to hear birds chirping, see green trees, and feel uneven ground under your feet. Those predictions are your brain's hypothesis about what will happen next. As you continue your walk, your brain is constantly receiving sensory input, the actual sights, sounds, and sensations of the forest. When the sensory data match your brain's predictions, the experience feels seamless and expected. Hearing birds chirping confirms your brain's expectation, so you may not even pay attention to it. However, if you suddenly hear a rustling noise that's out of place, your brain takes notice. This unexpected input is a prediction error. It does not match what your brain expected. In response, your brain updates its predictions. It might hypothesize that the rustling was caused by an animal, leading you to become more alert and cautious. In this scenario, your brain is not just passively reacting to the sounds and the sights. Instead, it's actively predicting what you will experience and adjusting those predictions with each step you take. This constant process of prediction and adjustment helps you navigate the world more efficiently, allow you to adapt to new environments and learn from experiences that don't match your expectations. Predicting processing is how your brain operates all the time with every sensory input. By framing the brain's activity as an ongoing experiment where hypotheses are constantly made and tested, predictive processing provides a dynamic understanding of perception, cognition, and the essence of how we interact with the world around us. Predictive processing is deeply rooted in Bayesian inference. It suggests that the brain operates in a probabilistic manner, constantly updating its beliefs in light of new evidence. This process allows the brain to weigh the reliability of sensory input against its prediction, adjusting beliefs based on the likelihood of various outcomes. The brain's predictions are not always guesses, but informed estimates that integrate past experiences with present context to anticipate, to predict future events. A central aspect of predictive processing is to minimize prediction errors. When sensory input diverges from the brain's predictions, this discrepancy or prediction error signals the need or adjustment. This error minimization mechanism is at the heart of learning and adaptation. Through repeated cycles of prediction, error detection, and model updating, the brain refines its internal models of the world, enhancing its predictive accuracy over time. How does our brain's predictive processing apply to trust, which is a fundamental aspect of human relationships and leadership? Trust can be conceptualized as a predictive belief in the reliability and the behavior of others, underpinned by the brain's capacity to predict and adjust based on the history of interactions and past outcomes. This trust is built and reinforced through continuous cycle of prediction and adjustment, similar to how the brain minimizes prediction errors. When someone constantly behaves in a way that aligns with your predictions, the prediction errors are minimal, and your trust in that person is strengthened. On the other hand, when that person's actions significantly diverge from what you anticipated, resulting in a high prediction error, your trust is then diminished. Your prediction is wrong. You'll need to recalibrate your expectations and beliefs about that individual. Trust is not given. We'll have to earn the trust. How to earn other people's trust? In the context of social relationships, leadership, and organizational dynamics, it means we need to reduce others' prediction errors. To do so, we need to be consistent, reliable, and transparent to reduce prediction errors and minimize uncertainty and anxiety among team members. Consistency in actions and decisions helps to establish a pattern that others can learn and predict. When people know what to expect from their leaders, it reduces the cognitive load of trying to guess or anticipate different responses. This predictability makes it easier for team members to trust that their leaders will act in accordance with stated values and goals. Reliability goes hand in hand with consistency, but it focuses more on following through on commitments and promises. When leaders reliably deliver on their obligations, it reinforces the trust that team members place in them. Reliability ensures that expectations are met, further reducing prediction errors and building confidence in leadership. Transparency means openly sharing information, the reasoning behind decisions, and the future plans as much as possible. It allows team members to have a clear understanding of the situation, including the challenges and uncertainties that may be present. Transparency helps in aligning team members' predictions with the reality of the organization's directions and decisions, minimizing prediction errors that can erode trust. Why do our brain engage in predictive processing? It is our brain's efficient, sophisticated way to navigate an inherently uncertain world. At its core, the primary goal of predictive processing is to reduce uncertainty, improve efficiency, and conserve metabolic resources. The brain is one of the most energy-demanding organs in our human body, and it continuously seeks ways to optimize its energy consumption. By predicting future events and preparing responses in advance, your brain reduces the need for constant real-time analysis of every new piece of sensory information. This not only conserves energy, but also enables quicker, more efficient responses to environmental stimuli. Predictive processing also plays a crucial role in refining our perceptions of the world. By using past experiences to inform current predictions, the brain filters sensory input, highlighting what is novel or unexpected, and downplaying or ignoring what matches its predictions. This filtering mechanism enhances the accuracy of our predictions, allowing us to focus on what is most relevant or potentially threatening, thereby improving our ability to interact with and navigate our environment. Let's apply predictive processing to the context of voting in the television show Survivor, where contestants must outwit, outplay, outlast each other to win. In Survivor's strategic alliances, if a contestant expected a fellow player to support them, but then overhears a conversation suggesting otherwise, this discrepancy between expectation and reality, which is a prediction error, prompts a rapid reassessment of the situation. The contestant must update their internal model of alliances and the strategies based on this new information, possibly changing their vote to adapt to the new social dynamics. By forming predictions about what it expected to counter, the human brain can prepare for action and responses more efficiently, conserving resources for when they are most needed. This proactive approach to perception and action allows for smoother navigation through a world that is by nature unpredictable. Predictive processing operates on the hierarchical system in the brain. The brain's hierarchical ranges from lower-level sensory regions, which processes direct input from the environment, such as visual or audio information, to higher-level cognitive areas that handle complex thoughts, plans, and predictions about the future. Higher-level areas may generate predictions based on abstract concepts or accumulated knowledge, such as anticipating a friend's reaction to news based on understanding their personality and past behavior. Lower levels, by contrast, deal with more immediate, concrete sensory input, like recognizing the friend's facial expressions during the conversation. For example, you learn to play a new piece on the piano. Initially, your brain's high-level areas generate a broad prediction about the piece, its rhythm, melody, and emotional expression. As you start to play, lower-level sensory areas process the tactile feedback from hitting the keys and the auditory feedback from the sounds produced. Before you press any keys, your brain predicts the sensory experience of playing the piece, including which keys to press and the resulting sound. These top-down predictions are based on your understanding of music history, the piano's layout, and your memory's similar pieces. As you play, you may hit a wrong note, producing an unexpected sound, a prediction error. This error is sent from the sensory area, hearing the wrong note, back up to the high cognitive brain areas. The high-level brain areas adjust the predictions based on the error feedback. Perhaps you realize the mistake was due to a misinterpretation of the sheet music or a lapse in concentration. Your brain updates its model of how to play the piece, refining the predictions sent down to your fingers. This process of making predictions, comparing them to actual sensory inputs, and then adjusting based on any error, it's a continuous loop. It happens at all levels of the brain's hierarchy, from the most basic sensory input to complex abstract thoughts. This ongoing dialogue ensures that our brain's model of the world is constantly being refined and updated, allowing us to learn from our experiences, adjust to new information, and make more accurate predictions about future events. The brain's continuous loop of prediction, error detection, error correction, and prediction updating is a model for organizational learning. Leaders can create environments where the feedback is valued and mistakes are seen as opportunities for learning rather than failures to be penalized. In organizations, a big problem is that it is difficult for bottom-up communication to reach leaders, administrators, and managers. This is because organizations' hierarchical structure often inhibit open communication, creating barriers that prevent important insights and feedback from lower levels of the organization from reaching the top. In many cases, the fear of retribution or the cultural norms that prioritize agreement over dissent discourage employees from sharing their honest observations and concerns. Moreover, layers of bureaucracy can slow the flow of information, distorting or diluting the feedback by the time it reaches decision makers. This breakdown in communication can lead to leaders making decisions based on outdated or incomplete information, significantly impacting the organization's ability to adapt and innovate effectively. To address this challenge, leaders can take inspiration from the brain's model of predictive processing, emphasizing a more integrated and responsive approach to organizational structure and communication. By creating an environment that encourages direct feedback loops and flattens organizational hierarchies, leaders can ensure that valuable bottom-up insights are heard and incorporated in decision-making processes. Just as the brain adjusts its predictions based on new sensory input, so too can organizations become more adaptable and resilient by valuing and integrating feedback from all levels of the organization.